This is an electric isostatic press. It has two modules of electric pressurization and manual pressurization. Here I will give you a demonstration of pressing samples. This cavity is 50 caliber, depth is 100. Its maximum pressure is 60 tons. Maximum formation is 50. Now let's get a sample. This is a rubber mold. First we put the sample into the mold. Spoon by spoon. And then we wrap it. Seal it at both ends. So that the ends do not loosen when pressurized. Then wrap it with tape. Samples are packaged. We put it in the chamber. Oil may be too much. Let's suck some of the oil out. Then we put the plunger on. Put a good position. Add a little oil from above. Then screw the inlet. We screwed the top very tight. Done. We turn these two screws up. Then lower the cylinder. Screw tight to the center of this mold. The mold is ready. Close the door. We start pressurizing. There are manual model and electric model. Tighten the antioxidation plug first. This is manual pressurization. We can see the pressure gauge is changing. This pressure can be precisely controlled. There is also electric pressurization. Electric pressurization controlled by pressure gauge. First we press the model button. Then press the up and down buttons to select one to enter the menu. There are two values of A and EF. A is the automatic pressure supplement mode. Just set it to 0.1. Generally do not need to automatically fill pressure. If necessary, set it to be a little smaller than EF. When that pressure falls below this value, the system will automatically replenish the pressure. EF is the maximum pressure. When the pressure reaches 28 megapascals, it will automatically stop pressurizing. Let's test it now. This time, we set the pressure to 10 PA. Press the end button to exit and save. This is the emergency stop button. You can press and hold it at any time to stop the machine. Open it, the system can start normally. This is a start button. We press the start button now to pressurize. Pressurizing. Reach the maximum pressure. At this time, pressure can be added manually to precisely control the pressure. Manual pressurization is mainly for precise control. For example, manual pressurization to 11 megapascals. Manual is not suitable for long-term pressurization. Take out the sample now. First turn off the power. Then slowly loosen the oil release valve. The cylinder slowly returned to its original position. Okay. Now get this cylinder out. First unscrew it. Usually it can't be pulled out directly. Loosen the bleed screw first. There is no way to open it without loosening and deflating it. Took it out. It can be pulled out by hand. Also, we can rotate the plunger to pull it out. This saves effort. Generally, we use the second method. Okay, already opened. Then take the sample. Open it and have a look. inside is dry. Nice sample.